Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1660. Floating box that stays visible while scrolling. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jell, and today's question sent in. I'm wondering if we can create a floating box in Excel 2010 with values in it, and then when we scroll up or down in the sheet, the box will go up or down. I think what they mean is we want to keep the box visible even while we scroll. So, like right there, the box is going away. We want to make sure that box is always visible. So, here's the steps. It's a little bit complicated, but not that complicated. All right, we're going to switch over to VBA first. Alt F11. In VBA, we're going to insert a form. We're going to insert a module. All right, so there's the module. Let's go back to the user form and do that first. Double click on the user form. Let's make it be the right size. You can make it be any size you want. Horrible caption of user form 1. So while the form is selected, find the caption and let's just say today's order total. All right, now this is right now is a blank form. We have to put something on it. We have a choice of a label or a text box. But a text box would let them type something. I just want to communicate something. So let's draw a label in there. And that should be more than enough size. And when I click on this, I see that it's called label 1. I can rename this if I want, like LAB total. You don't have to do that, but you do have to remember this name. Okay, now some code to make it all work. We're going to right click the form and say view code. They start out with user form click. I want to change that to user form initialize. And what we do is say me.labtotal.caption is equal to the format of something, comma, in quotes, dollar sign, pound, comma, pound, pound, 0.00. I don't need to show them the sentence. Okay, format is just like text in regular Excel, but in VBA we call it format. All right, now what are we going to put in here? This is going to be worksheets sheet 1 dot range e1 dot value, and I'm going to switch back. I missed a parenthesis right there. Worksheet sheet 1 range e1 dot value. I'm going to switch back to Excel and make sure that's right. Yeah, e1. Okay, good. And that's it. I'm going to save this line of code. Control C because I'm going to need it again later. We don't need this tiny little macro up here. All right, so we have a user form initialize that shows us that total. But as those totals change, we need something to happen. So you see that we're on sheet 1 down here. So I'm going to go to the sheet 1 code pane. I'm going to double click on sheet 1. And from the left drop down, I'm going to choose worksheet. It's the only choice. From the right drop down, I'm going to say calculate. Every time that this sheet calculates, we want to update the user form with that value. And instead of me dot, we have to say here form, we just call it user form 1. That's not very good. Hang on. Let's come here to user form 1. I'm going to double click. I thought I changed the name of this, but I guess that was when I was testing. So instead of user form 1, I'm going to call it form total. That way, in case we have more than one form later. And then here, this is form total, FRM total. All right. So what do we have? We have an event handler here that every time that the worksheet calculates, it updates the name on the form. We have module 1, which is where we're going to show the form. FormTotal.show and modal. Modal is going to be false. Usually a modal form takes control and you can only see, you can't do anything else in the spreadsheet, but if we make it be a modeless form, then it will just stay put. All right, so to recap, we have, I guess, four elements. We have a user form where we added a label, we added some code to that user form to initialize it with the value from E1. We added some code to sheet 1 to update the form, and then we added a simple little one-line macro here to show the form. Now back in Excel, we're going to do Alt F8. There's our show form. Let's assign this to what? Control Shift F for form, or you choose, I don't care. click OK, click Cancel. Now, whenever we want to see that form, Control Shift F, it appears. And as we change some numbers, see the total updates. That's beautiful. And I'm going to put it in one place. I'm going to put it right there. And as I scroll through the data, it continues to stay in exactly the place where I put it. All right, so I think that is what we're looking for, a modeless user form that eventually becomes a box. There's not even a button on here. If we want to get rid of it, just click the X and it will go away. Control Shift S or Control Shift F for form, and it comes back. And choose the place to put it. Okay, well, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast, Mr. Excel.